Oh, is it good to be back? Welcome back, everyone, to a much anticipated, long awaited. Welcome back, everyone, to a much anticipated, long awaited fast food review. That's right, everyone. I am back in the US of A, back in America. And you know what that means? It's time to get back to the fast food. For the past, almost three weeks, but it's really been close to a month. I've been traveling, I've been to Canada, I've been to Europe, I've been all over. And well, I haven't been doing the best job as the king of the fast foodies, getting you guys the fast food reviews. But now that I'm back in the States, you better believe that fast food reviews are gonna be dropping left and right as quickly as I can get my hands on all the brand new, the newest, latest, the greatest fast food items, snacks, ice cream, cereals, whatever it may be. So go ahead, smash that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any of the exciting, upcoming, brand new content. Now, what fast food did I decide to break my fast food? I'm getting so excited, having trouble talking. Hiatus with? Well, you see, as I just mentioned, I was over in Europe, Italy specifically, for a week or two. And besides, you know, what is Italy known for? Pasta, pizza, besides all that, Italy also has some very good croissants. And so when I saw that Dunkin' came out with a brand new ham and Swiss stuffed croissant, I thought, why not kickstart the brand new fast food reviews that I'm gonna be dropping here on this channel with a Europe and Italian inspired fast food item. And since I was just in Italy, I can compare this to the croissants I had over there and see just how authentic Dunkin' Donuts can make this croissant. Now, besides this ham and Swiss stuffed croissant, they also came out with some new, I believe they're called Dunkin' Wraps. They have two varieties of those. If you want me to review those as well, then comment down below and let me know, and I'm pretty sure I'll be able to get my hands on those. But coming back to this stuffed ham and Swiss croissant, I gotta give it to Dunkin'. I ordered this online, and within like a minute or two, it was ready for me, and it was hot to the touch. It was so hot, I had trouble picking it up with the bag. That's how hot it was. And now I drove home, and 10, 15 minutes later, it's still warm to the touch. So I am already pretty impressed. This review is off to a good start, but it doesn't matter if the croissant is warm if it doesn't taste good. Am I right? I'm right. So let's go ahead and taste this. Actually, let me split it open to see just how stuffed it is. I'm actually dropping a review of some caramel chocolate that my grandmother and I reviewed, and that was stuffed with some good caramel. So I'm hoping that this croissant is as stuffed as that caramel chocolate was.
That's good. Mm-hmm. Yeah, a lot of caramel in there.
Okay. So it looks like there's some ham and Swiss cheese in there. Who would have guessed? In a ham and Swiss stuffed croissant sandwich, it'd be ham and Swiss cheese in there.
Well, duh.
It looks to be like a decent amount though. Look at that. At least a lot of ham. I'm not seeing too much of that Swiss cheese. Speaking of Swiss cheese, I was also just in Switzerland. Although, I don't know if I had any Swiss cheese in Switzerland. I should have gotten Swiss cheese in Switzerland. That's like a once in a lifetime opportunity, you know, to have Swiss cheese in Switzerland. Oh well, at least I get it in Dunkin' Donuts. I gotta give it to Dunkin'. This is pretty good. Now, is this ham and Swiss stuffed croissant as flaky, as buttery, as soft, as crunchy as the croissants over in Italy? No, no, but honestly, I wasn't expecting it to be. However, this is a pretty darn good croissant. It is soft, it is buttery, it is flaky. I mean, look. There's some flakiness going on. Actually, I am surprised. Honestly, I thought they were just gonna give me a cold croissant with a slice of ham inside and a slice of cheese. But this is warm. As I mentioned, it was hot to the touch when I first got it. The Swiss cheese is actually melted inside. And the top, it's not undercooked, not overcooked. I was not expecting this, honestly. I gotta give it to Dunkin' Donuts. And that's coming from someone who just came from, as I said, Italy, where they know their croissants, and Switzerland, where they know their Swiss cheese. Yeah, I mean, this was like just barely $4. I think 350 calories. Not too bad. I gotta be honest, quick pick-me-up. You know, if you're running late for work in the morning, you need something for breakfast. It's warm. I'm not mad one bit, to be honest. I really don't know what else to say. The croissant itself tastes good. There's a little bit of saltiness in there. Not super salty by any means, but it has some flavor to it. It's not just cold bread. Duncan, you outdid yourself with this. For ratings, I'm gonna have to go ahead and give it a 8.5 out of 10. Honestly, when I clicked that place order button, I was expecting to be giving this like a 6 out of 10. But here we are. I'm enjoying myself. I'm having a good time. Maybe it's just I haven't had fast food in, you know, a month and I forgot what it tastes like. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this review. Let me know in the comments down below. Have you tried this new ham and Swiss stuffed croissant from Dunkin' Donuts? Was your experience as good as mine? Let me know and we'll see you in the next one. If you made it to the end of this video, then I'm sure that you want to become a fast foodie as well. So all you have to do is hit that subscribe button. And to see exclusive behind the scenes footage, then you can head on over to Instagram and follow the Fast Foodies at Fast Foodies Review.